physiological loss in weight in quality in weight and quality. Okay, so after the harvesting, how weight is lost in harvested fruits and vegetables? The loss in weight has derived by subtracting the weight of food on the date from the original fresh weight. That means the weight loss from harvesting to हार्वेस्टिंग टू म्हणजे जे काय तुम्ही हार्वेस्ट करतात म्हणजे हार्वेस्टिंग केल्यानंतर एक फर्स्ट जे ओरिजिनल वेट आहे ते हार्वेस्ट केल्यानंतरचा वेट आणि त्यानंतर तुम्ही जवळपास 3 ते 4 दिवसांपर्यंत तुम्ही त्याची रीडिंग घेऊ शकतात. मग ती असेल तुमची फायनल वेट. मग त्यावेळेत ओरिजिन हॅलो, आवाज येतोय?
हो मॅम, येतोय.
द परसेंटेज लॉस इन वेट नियर कॅल्क्युलेटेड बाय द फॉर्मुला डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट फ्रूट अँड व्हेजिटेबल पेरिशेबल प्रोडक्ट विच ऍक्टिव्हली मेटाबोलाइज ड्यूरिंग द पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट फेज. तर हार्वेस्टिंग केल्यापासून तर साधारणतः 4 ते 5 दिवसांमध्ये त्याच्यामध्ये किती लॉस होतो, वेट लॉस किती प्रमाणामध्ये होतो ते आपल्याला ह्या प्रॅक्टिकल मध्ये डिटरमाइन करायचं आहे. त्याची प्रोसिजर बघू आपण. फ्रेश हॉर्टिकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस कंटेंट स्टोअर फूड अँड वॉटर ऍज मेजर कॉन्स्टिट्युंट. बोथ स्टोअर फूड अँड वॉटर कॉन्ट्रीब्युट टू वेट. If the water and store food are lost, then there is a loss of stable weight. Okay, तर जे काही फ्रुट्स आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये वॉटर आणि प्लस फूड म्हणजे जे काही कंटेंट असतात त्याच्यामध्ये म्हणजेच ज्याला आपण म्हणतो की सपोज कार्बोहायड्रेट्स प्रोटीन विटॅमिन्स वगैरे जे काही पूर्ण कंपोजिशन जे फ्रुट्स असतं तर ते त्याचं वेट प्लस वॉटर हे सगळ्यांचं वेट पकडून पूर्ण वेट जे आहे ते फ्रुट्स असतं. तर त्याच्यामध्ये किती प्रमाणामध्ये लॉस होतो तुमचा स्टोअर फ्रूट मध्ये वॉटर आणि फूड कंटेंट म्हणून. वेन दिस टू आर सब्जेक्टेड टू लॉस ड्यू टू द फिजिओलॉजिकल प्रोसेस नेमली रेस्पिरेशन अँड ट्रान्सपोर्टेशन विल रिझल्टिंग इन लॉस ऑफ वेट. सो द वेट लॉस ड्यूरिंग द फिजिओलॉजिकल प्रोसेस नेमली रेस्पिरेशन अँड ट्रान्सपोर्टेशन. ओके, दिस लॉस इन वेट ड्यू टू द फिजिओलॉजिकल प्रोसेस टर्म फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट PLW फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट. वॉटर लॉस इन लॉस ऑफ सोल्युबल वेट अँड देर इज अ डायरेक्ट लॉस इन मार्केटिंग. Formula for determining physiological loss in weight is equal to initial weight, that is W0 minus final weight W1 into 100 divided by initial weight. Okay, so W0, that means initial weight at the time of harvesting, original weight, that is called initial weight, minus final weight, that means final weight how many days to take food for the determining physiological loss in weight. So the last day of weight is the final weight into 100 and divided by initial weight. This is the physiological loss in weight is determined in percentage. Observation for this practical, we can take any fruit. For example, if you take a banana, so the first name of the commodity, then quality of fruit. If you take a banana, so the quality of banana, date of initial reading, first initial reading, that means the harvesting time, harvesting date, weight of the first day, after harvesting next day, that is first day, then date of the fifth day, okay, after harvesting fifth day, then day weight of sixth day, fifth day is the weight ghayche, tyanantar weight of bunch, packing material use. This is observation and formula, initial weight minus final weight into 100 divided by initial weight. त्याच्यामध्ये तुम्हाला काय करायचं, जर सपोज तुम्ही बनाना फ्रूट घेतलं आणि बनाना फ्रूट तुम्ही इंडिव्हिज्युअल वेट घेऊ शकतात, म्हणजे इंडिव्हिज्युअल फिंगर्सचं पण तुम्ही कॅल्क्युलेशन करू शकतात, किंवा डायरेक्ट पूर्ण बंच जर असेल तर बंचचं पण तुम्ही पूर्ण काउंट करू शकता. ओके, सो फर्स्ट डेला जर सपोज बनानाचं वेट असेल, सपोज फिंगर्सचं बघूया आपण, फिंगर्सचं वेट असेल सपोज 50 ग्राम, ओके, किंवा 60 ग्राम वेट असेल त्याचं इनिशियल वेट हार्वेस्टिंगला, आणि त्यातून मायनस तुम्ही 5 दिवस त्याचं रिडिंग घेतलेलं आहे हार्वेस्टिंग पासून पुढचे 5 दिवस, ओके, मग त्याच्यामध्ये तुम्ही फर्स्ट डेला रिडिंग घ्याल, सेकंड डेला रिडिंग घ्याल, थर्ड डेला रिडिंग घ्याल, फिफ्थला, ओके, लास्ट फायनल वेट असेल तुमचं फिफ्थ डेचं, आणि फिफ्थ डेला किती वेट असेल तुमचं ते ज्या वेळेला तुम्ही रिडिंग घ्याल त्यावेळेला तुम्हाला समजेल. सपोज फर्स्ट डेला तुमचं जर 50 ग्राम असेल तर फायनल डेला तुमचं जवळपास 35 to 40 ग्राम पर्यंत वेट लॉस होईल त्याचं, मग डिवाइड इन टू 100 देन डिवाइडेड बाय इनिशियल वेट. सो दिस इज फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट, दिस इज द फॉर्म्युला फॉर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग द फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट. अशा प्रकारे तुम्हाला जे काही प्रॅक्टिकल आहे ते प्रॅक्टिकल कम्प्लीट करायचं होतं. मग रिझल्ट जो आहे तर रिझल्ट बघूया आपण. जर सपोज तुम्ही फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड आणि फोर्थ डे पर्यंत जर रिडिंग घेतले तर पहिल्या दिवशी काय रिडिंग आलं, सेकंड डेला काय रिडिंग आलं, थर्डला आणि फोर्थला, आणि ऍव्हरेज ज्या वेळेला तुमचं पूर्ण रिडिंग जे आहे तर ते रिडिंग काउंट करून ऍव्हरेज ऑफ फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट बघायचं किती आलंय, पूर्ण ज्या रिडिंग आहे त्याला डिवाइडेड बाय, जर सपोज 4 रिडिंग तुम्ही घेतलेले असेल तर टोटल 4 रिडिंग प्लस करायचे आणि त्याला डिवाइड बाय 4 करायचं, म्हणजे तुमचं टोटल जे काही आहे तर ते पूर्ण किती वेट लॉस झालं हे तुम्हाला त्याच्यामध्ये समजेल. ओके, आफ्टर 6 डे फ्रुट्स विल बी ओव्हर रायपन अँड फायनली रॉटन. द फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस इन वेट ऑफ बनाना फ्रूट इन कोरुगेटेड फायबर बॉक्स इज, ओके, देन पॅकिंग मटेरियल इज पॅक फॉर द ट्रान्सपोर्टेशन ऑर मार्केट. सो 4 दिवसानंतर किंवा 5 दिवसानंतर ज्या वेळेला तुमचं जे काही फ्रुट्स आहेत ते फ्रुट्स पूर्णपणे ओव्हर राईप झालेलं असतं, ओके, आणि त्यानंतर ते म्हणजे खराब होऊन जातं. ठीक आहे, तर अशा प्रकारे तुम्हाला फिजिओलॉजिकल लॉस किती प्रमाणामध्ये वेट लॉस होतो हे काढू शकता तुम्ही. समजलंय सर्वांना हे प्रॅक्टिकल कसं करायचं होतं? ऍक्च्युली आपण जर कॉलेजमध्ये असतो तर हे प्रॅक्टिकल आपल्याला करता आलं असतं, ठीक आहे, पण आता तुम्हाला मला असं वाटतं समजलं असेल की मी तुम्हाला काय सांगते, की फक्त पहिल्यांदा तुम्हाला एक रिडिंग घ्यायचंय, जे कोणतं फ्रूट तुम्ही बनानाच नाही कोणतंही फ्रूट तिथे घेऊ शकता, बनाना असेल किंवा ऍपल असेल, गोवा असेल, कस्टर्ड ऍपल असेल, कोणतंही फ्रूट तुम्ही घ्या, इनिशियल वेट घ्या आणि फायनल वेट घ्या, त्याला इंटू 100 करा. परसेंट मध्ये आपल्याला रिडिंग घ्यायचे किंवा आन्सर जे आहे ते परसेंट मध्ये कॅल्क्युलेट करायचंय, म्हणून इंटू 100 करा आणि डिवाइड परत इनिशियल वेट करा, त्याप्रमाणे तुमचं जे काही आन्सर आहे ते आन्सर तुम्हाला भेटून जाईल. ठीक आहे, ह्या प्रॅक्टिकल मध्ये हे आपल्याला शिकायचं होतं. त्यानंतर नेक्स्ट प्रॅक्टिकल आहे पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट डिसऑर्डर इन हॉर्टिकल्चरल प्रोड्यूस. Post harvest disorder are common in many crops where storage at low temperature for a long period is required. The most important non-pathological problem encountered in the market chain is a physiological disorder. So the physiological disorder is a non-pathological disorder. Okay, pathological problem. It is a physiological disorder. Physiological disorder refers to breakdown of tissue in a response to an adverse environment, particularly temperature and nutritional deficiency during growth and development. So, what is meant by physiological disorder? It is the breakdown of tissue in a response to adverse environment, particularly temperature and nutritional deficiency during growth and development. Okay. So this is the physiological disorder occurred due to the environmental factor like temperature and some of the nutritional deficiency. Metabolic disturbance occurring at a reduced temperature are generally divided into two main groups. First is a chilling injury. Metabolic disturbance occurring at reduced temperature. At the time, if the temperature is reduced, metabolic disturbance are occur. That is, in that one, first is a chilling injury. Result from exposure of tissue due to temperature below critical level. Injury is caused due to the change in physical state of membrane, lipids, dissociation of enzymes and other proteins. So, chilling injury, that means the lower down the temperature. And the tissue is exposed to this temperature at temperature below critical level. That means the temperature below 0 degrees Celsius. That is called as chilling injury. Then physiological disorder. Problems which arise other than the chilling injury, physiological disorder involve the plant breakdown. Plant tissue breakdown that is not directly caused either by pest and disease or by mechanical damage, which includes tissue disruption upon the ice crystal formation associated with freezing injury. So plant tissue is breakdown not directly either by pest and disease or by mechanical damage, but it includes the tissue disruption upon the ice crystal formation in the freezing injury. Physiological disorder may develop in a response to various pre and post harvest condition. Pre, that means nutrient accumulation or deficiency, and post, low temperature stress during storage condition. So the main reason of physiological disorder is pre-harvest factor and post-harvest factors. In pre-harvest factors, some of the nutrient deficiency and nutrient accumulation, and post-harvest factor is low temperature stays during storage. So the physiological disorder can be divided into 5 general categories. First one is the nutritional. Example, bitter pit in apple, blossom end rot in water. Blossom end rot in watermelon and tomato. This is the nutritional deficiency. Nutritional due to disorder occur due to the nutritional deficiency. That is calcium. Due to the lack of calcium, the bitter pit in apple and blossom end rot in watermelon and tomato occur. Then temperature, low and high temperature. Example, sunburn on the shoulders of tomato and mango. High temperature injury occurred prior to harvest. This is the environmental factors are responsible for the physiological disorder, high temperature and low temperature. Then respiratory, low oxygen and high carbon dioxide concentration in and or around the harvested produce in controlled atmospheric storage and modified atmospheric packaging. So this disorder occur at after the harvesting, at the time of storage condition. Okay, if the low temperature and high carbon dioxide concentration in at the time of storage, that is controlled atmosphere in control atmosphere or in modified atmospheric packaging. That time, this type of physiological disorder may be occur. For example, black heart of potato due to the low oxygen injury. Then senescent example, mealiness in apples are due to the harvesting over mature produce or over the stored storing produce. Mealiness, okay, due to the harvesting over mature fruits. Then miscellaneous disorder, which are product specific in terms of symptoms expressed. Example, bitterness, isocumarin accumulation in carrot, greening of potato due to the exposed to sunlight. Then rotting of onion exposed to high humidity. Then russet sprouting on the midrib of lettuce leaves to lettuce leaves exposure to ethylene. This is the factors are responsible for the physiological disorder. Then nutritional and low temperature disorder are more problematic than others. The cellular, biochemical and physiological mechanism that give a rise to physiological disorder in produce are extremely complex. Moreover, they often involve elution and interaction with the pre and post harvest condition. Causes of physiological disorder are first pre harvest environmental condition. In environmental condition like temperature, nutrition, water regimes and crop development factor, example yield or crop load, position on the plant, carbohydrates, water and nutrient partitioning. So this is the pre-harvest factor responsible for the physiological disorder. And then post-harvest environmental conditions, this is the post-harvest condition, and this the produce or the fruits and vegetables are stored in a storehouses, different storage condition. And that type, temperature, gas, and storage times are responsible for the physiological disorder. First one, mineral deficiency disorder. Disorder associated with deficiencies of specific minerals whose symptoms are sometimes expressed only after harvest in a fruits may be prevented by providing the specific mineral in elements either during growth or after harvest. Okay, so so some of the symptoms are expressed only after the harvest, and that time this type of disorder can be prevented by providing the specific mineral element either during the growth and after the harvest. So first one is the calcium. How to overcome the physiological disorder? Calcium is associated with more post-harvest related deficiency disorder than any other minerals. Okay, so the calcium deficiency disorder such as blossom end rot of tomatoes can be eliminated. Can be eliminated by applying the calcium salt as pre-harvest spray. That means in the field condition, you have to spray calcium salt. Then next one, for the other such as bitter pit of apple, only partial control is obtained by pre-harvest spray. Variability in the extent of control achieved is probably related to amount of calcium taken by the fruit. Okay, so in bitter pit of apple, this is also the calcium deficiency disorder. But if you apply the partial, if you apply the calcium at the time of field condition, not a fully control on the bitter pit, but the partial control can be possible through application of calcium. Then post-harvest DP, which markedly increase the uptake of calcium, can result in total elimination of bitter pit. Then added calcium may possibly prevent some disorder by strengthening these structural components without alleviating the original cause of disorder. So this is the calcium related disorder of fruits and vegetables. In carrot, the deficiency disorder is cavity spot or cracking. Then celery, blackheart, Chinese cabbage, internal tea bud, Brussels sprout, internal browning, tomato, blossom end rot, mango, soft nose, pear, cork spot, apple, bitter pit, cracking, internal breakdown, and avocado, end spot. This is the photographs of calcium deficiency disorder. Apple, bitter pit in apple. Then blossom end rot. This is the blossom end rot fruit, tomato. Then Brussels sprout, internal browning. Next one is the boron deficiency. Boron deficiency in apple leads to condition known as internal cork. This condition is marked by pitting on the fresh and is often indistinguishable from the bitter pit. The difference between internal cork, bitter pit prevented by applying boron spray response to calcium treatment. Only develop on the tree develop after the harvest. So the internal breakdown and internal cork and bitter pit is the same symptoms, but internal cork is observed due to the boron deficiency and bitter pit due to the calcium deficiency. Then potassium. The major mineral in plants is potassium, and both high and low level of potassium have been associated with abnormal metabolism. High potassium and also magnesium and low calcium has been associated with the development of bitter pit in apple. Low potassium delays the development of full red color and by inhibiting lycopene biosynthesis in tomato. Okay, so the temperate nutrients, major potassium is a major mineral nutrient, major mineral nutrients in a plant. Both high and low level of potassium have been associated with abnormal metabolism in plants. So high potassium and low calcium has been associated with development of bitter pit in apple. And low potassium can delay the development of full red color in tomato by inhibiting the lycopene photosynthesis. Okay. So heavy metals, next one is the copper. Copper acts as a catalyst for enzyme system that leads to enzymatic browning, such as browning of cut and damaged tissue that exposed to air. The level of these metals are derived important in process of fruits and vegetables, whether they are derived from produce or from metal impurities acquired during the processing. Okay, so this is the mineral deficiency or the nutrient deficiency disorder. This is all about the major physiological disorder of horticultural produce. Okay.